Hey, looking for a career in data analytics? Or are you already a data analyst looking forward to upgrade your skills? If so, I have a question for you guys. What makes your CV stands out? Let me know your answers in the comment section below. But you will agree with me when I say it is vital indeed to earn a certification that validates your skills and glorifies your CV. You must have heard about Microsoft. Not only its services, but its certifications are quite popular nowadays. You know, these certifications help you keep pace with ever-evolving technical requirements and boost your productivity. So yes, welcome back to another session by K21 Academy. In today's session, I will talk about yet another certification by Microsoft named DA100, Analyzing Data with Power BI and Everything You Need to Know. Before we move on, let me first walk you through our today's agenda. We will start this session by having little introduction about what is Power BI, and we'll see who uses the Power BI majorly. Further, we will understand various roles and responsibility of a data analyst. Moving ahead, we will discuss what is DA100 exam, and we'll see the prerequisite required for DA100. Further, we will discuss why one should take DA100 exam and discuss the DA100 certification advantages. Next, we are going to discuss what is examination format that you should know and the skills measured in the exam. And yes, don't forget to watch exam red tape and salary trend in the end. So without any further ado, let's get started. First of all, let's have a little introduction of what is Power BI. So basically, Power BI is a business intelligence tool that helps transform raw data from data sources into valuable and informative insights. Let's understand this way. Unstructured data from various sources like Excel, CSV files, Java APIs, web files, SQL, and so on are loaded into Power BI, which is in fact a collection of architectures, processes, technologies, and services working together to present data into meaningful insights. You know, these insights can be in various forms like graph, charts, reports, and dashboards. As a result, Power BI is also known as data visualization tool. Okay, now I have to ask you one simple question. Have you worked on Power BI before? If yes, here's something we can both agree on. That is, Power BI really has a simple interface, and working on it is relatively quick and easy process. So moving ahead, let's see who uses Power BI majorly. Let me say this very straight. Power BI is something different. It's unique and has become the market leader because the platform stretches the full scope of business intelligence and not just data visualization. Therefore, it has become the hot choice for many professionals like data engineers, database administrators, and of course, for data analysts and business intelligence professionals, it is like heart and soul of their business. Needless to say, as companies are switching to this awesome tool, demand for data analysts is automatically increasing. So let's see who is a data analyst and what does he do. Have you ever wondered how much data is created in tech-savvy world? You might be surprised to find out that the current estimate stands at 1.145 trillion megabyte per day. A lot, right? And that's not all. It keeps on increasing by each day. So what happens to this data? Well, that's where data analyst comes into picture. A data analyst collects those data, analyzes them, interprets them, and presents into functional and meaningful insights to solve business problems. Now let's get to the roles and responsibilities of a data analyst. Data analysts enable businesses to maximize their value and their assets. They clean and transform data and have advanced analytical capabilities to provide meaningful business value. As a subject matter expert, data analysts are responsible for designing and developing data models. They also help in delivering useful information. In addition to that, they communicate and collaborate with stakeholders to provide relevant insights based on identified requirements. Now let's move to the central topic of our today's session. But before that, are you ready to transit your career into the world of business intelligence? Then DA100 exam is the game changer you are looking for. But basically, what is DA100? Let's discuss that. The full name of this certification is GA100 Analyzing Data with Microsoft Power BI. As the name suggests, this particular exam is very specific to Microsoft Power BI within the capabilities of data analyst. It is one of the role-based associate level certification provided by Microsoft. You might know that Microsoft keeps on updating its certification. Therefore, it has replaced 7778 exam, which is Analyzing and Visualizing Data with Microsoft Power BI with GA100 exam. One point to be noted here is that it is a standalone certification, which means that you only have to give one exam, and if you clear the exam, you earn the certification. Moving forward, let's see prerequisite required for DA100 exam. If you take a whole picture, there is no such requirement. Although it's good to know data related skills such as handling of data, cleaning and visualizing of data. It is also expected to have a fundamental knowledge of data processing and data repositories, both on premises and in the cloud, to better understand the concept in this certification. See, the point is you are here today because you have decided to improve your data skills and gain knowledge in the crazy competitive world. You have taken the first important step. Just believe the process, you can do it. Now we have to answer the big question here. Should you take DA100 exam? To answer your question, let's consider a scenario. Imagine you went for an interview. You are competing with other people who have come for the same position as you. Let's say you are the one who has this DA100 exam certification. So what do you think? Who will be called for the interview first? If you guessed it's you, then you are absolutely right. So when you are in an interview, the examiner is looking at you and they might also be looking at other candidate CVs. So in any way that can set yourself apart will really help go a long way in terms of helping you land a job. So basically what does this certification do is it proves to the examiner that you are capable of taking this position, hit the ground running and be effective. Does that answer your question? If not, then definitely next part will do. Let's turn to discuss the advantages of DA100 certification. First of all, this certification validates your skills and helps you demonstrate your expertise and knowledge in Power BI. Not just that, it helps you attract lucrative salaries and give you a chance of working with top companies. The highly acclaimed Microsoft DA100 exam accelerates your career growth and definitely helps you climb up your professional ladder. You know, about 23% of Microsoft certified professionals reported receiving 20% hike in their salaries. It also enables you to chase further advanced goals in the IT field. Apart from that, you will make an immediate impact as a Microsoft certified professional. This credential will help you in getting notice and win recognition. Microsoft certifications provide you with a competitive edge over non-certified candidates. Again, it is estimated that certified employees earn 15% more than those without certifications and are nearly 20% more productive. Finally, this certification proves your skills and therefore enhances your employability by making you job ready. The whole reason we are taking this exam is not just to get the certificate, but also to validate that we know how to use all areas of the tool. So more than anything, this exam is intended to prove that. Trust me, it will all be worth it. Before sailing for the exam, it is essential to have an understanding of the exam format, right? So moving ahead to discuss some basic details about the DA100 exam. Starting with its name, the exam is popularly known as DA100 Analyzing Data with Microsoft Power BI. You will get 180 minutes to complete the exam, which I think is sufficient to meet all the questions requirement. Talking about the questions, you can expect around 40 to 60 questions subject to change over time. And yes, be prepared to see variation in question formats like it can be multiple choice, drag and drop, case studies, fill in the blanks, short answers and so on. But don't worry, majority of questions will be multiple choice. You need to score 700 marks out of 1000 to clear the exam. You will be awarded point for each correct answer. The cost of the exam depends on your location. To give you a rough idea, let's take an example of United States, where the exam fee is $165. Here I will suggest you to visit Microsoft's official site for an accurate price according to your country. Next, this exam is available in various languages like English, Japanese, Chinese, Korean, French, German, and Spanish. You can opt according to your convenience. So what do you think? Other than exam format is essential to consider for TA-100 exam? I can almost hear you thinking when you said skills measured. Alright, let's jump into discuss the skills measured in TA-100 exam. So due to constant feedback about the exam being difficult, Microsoft has decided to divide the entire syllabus into 5 modules. The first one is prepare the data. The second one is model the data. The third one is visualize the data. The fourth one is analyze the data. Fifth and the last one is deploy and maintain deliverables. Further, each domain is divided into subtopics to provide complete clarity about the exam, which we will discuss in the coming section. Now with this, let's move ahead and discuss the weightage of each domain. Talking about the first domain, prepare the data holds 20-25% weightage in the exam, which means that 10-12 questions are expected from this section. The next module, model the data, has weightage of 25-30%, resulting in approximately 13-15 questions in the exam. Visualize the data also holds 20-25%, same as prepare the data. The subsequent two modules, analyze the data and deploy and maintain deliverables, have same weightage, that is 10-15%, accounting for 3-5 questions each in the final exam. So it is clear that the percentage figure shown in front of you basically indicates the relative weightage of each module's question. Therefore, remember to devote enough time to domains with higher percentage. Now let's take a closer look at each domain and see what it holds. When we talk about preparing the data, the first thing you need to learn here is how to get data from different sources. I already have mentioned that Power BI is a powerful tool that allows you to extract data from almost any source and even merge that data into single file. Next, it covers the profiling of a data, which means that we need to identify data anomalies and examine the data structures, because we cannot keep our data full of bugs and errors, right? Because in the end, it will impact our analysis only. The third thing you will look after here is how to clean, transform and load data, which basically means how to structure, arrange and sort data to make it readable and easy to understand. And again, cleaning and transforming data is an essential step, because until and unless you sort your data, structure it, make it ready, you cannot model the data, which is the second domain of this TA-100 exam. When modeling data, the one thing we need to keep in mind is efficiency. Here, we will first design a data model. Next, we will try to develop a data model. Not just that, we will make use of DEX, Data Analytical Expression, a library full of operators and functions to create measures. During modeling the data, you must have the capability to optimize the model performance to make the best result out of it. As we discussed, modeling the data holds the highest weightage in the exam, so it becomes very important to learn about it and pay attention to it. After model the data, we need to present our data to visualize it. If you remember, I told you in the beginning that Power BI is also known as data visualization tool. So you must have the ability to create reports, to present data with the help of creative graphs, charts and so on. Next, here we will learn about how to create dashboards and make it interactive. So to deliver the best experience, you must understand what a good interface looks like and enrich reports for outstanding usability. So coming to the main part of analyze and interpret the data, where we analyze the reports and dashboards to draw insights and meaningful information. Also, you must have the capability to perform advanced analysis to draw insights. The last domain is deploy and maintain deliverables, which include managing the data sets and creating and managing workspace. Definitely something required in TA-100. So here are a few tips for your exam day. Run a system test before the exam. Keep the workstation clean, because the proctor will monitor the environment through the webcam. Remember, no breaks are allowed during the exam for any reason. Don't keep any electronic devices around you. As I said before, you will see variations in questions, So prepare according to it. The most significant to recollect is time management. Watch out and pace yourself on the questions. Do not grind to halt on a one question for very long. The best advice I can give you on exam day is take a deep breath, read the questions, formulate an answer without looking at the options, pick and move on, and you are good to go. Now let's get to the most awaited part and discuss what is the average salary of Power BI data analyst. Looking at the figures in India, we will see data analysts starting their career will get on average 4,22,000 rupees per annum. As they grow their skills and reach mid-level, they will get on average 6,90,000 rupees per annum. A person with full-grown experience will get something around 9,42,000 rupees per annum. Pretty good, right? Now let's see how much a Power BI data analyst gets in the United Kingdom. At entry level, data analyst will grab around 27,000 pounds per annum. At mid-level, they will get around 31,000 pounds per annum. A person with full experience will get around 34,000 pounds per annum. So, when we think about the salary aspect of a Power BI data analyst, whether it be a fresher or experienced, they attract lucrative packages. But here's the catch. If you have the right skill, you are certified, you are trained, and if you are good at what you do, you will get plenty. Just go and grab the opportunities with your talent and skills. By now, you will have understood why DA100 exam is relevant today. Becoming a Microsoft certified data analyst is obviously a smart career move. We have put on everything about the certification through the following learning path. So you will start with Microsoft Data Analytics and will learn about how to prepare data in Power BI. In second week, you will perform cleaning, transforming and loading of data in Power BI with designing a data model in Power BI. Third module will be about DAX and how to create measures in Power BI. Moving to fourth week, we will learn how to optimize model performance and create reports. Interactive and real-time dashboards will be covered in fifth week. Moving to next week, we will learn how to create paginated reports and perform advanced analytics. In seventh week, we will cover how to create and manage workspaces as well as datasets in Power BI. It also includes one of the most important topics, that is row-level security. So in this 8-week roadmap, we take you from basic to advanced level with important tips and resources for clearing DA100 exam. Once you are done with the certification, then you can start preparing for your CVs and start applying for jobs. The key to successfully pass an exam is by preparing right. You need to have the right set of resources with the right preparation guide to sail through it. So we present our specially curated guide, Microsoft Data Analyst Associate DA100, to help you pass the exam on the very first attempt. To assist you with this, we have got a complete guide which includes 13 modules, 30 plus lessons, 12 hands-on practice to be technically sound and conceptually crystal clear, 100 plus exam questions, CV preparation and on-job support for your better learning process. So if you are interested in this program, then I will highly recommend you to attend our free class. This interactive session will help you in gaining an understanding of why and who should learn data analyst platform, what is data analysis, how companies can benefit from data analyst, and of course, it will also guide you about Power BI architecture, Power BI desktop, and Power BI services. Apart from that, it also covers many other important topics. So if you are interested in this free class, you can visit k21academy.com/DA100-02. You can find this link in the description box below. Thank you for tuning in, guys.